When you first unbox your Model Club package, it may look like we've given you barely any paint. It's a little bit misleading, but because we had to separate paint out into so many small jars, it will be somewhat dried out looking or resemble a very thick paste. So, the first thing you need to do is reconstitute all of the colors. Add about 15 drops of clear paint thinner from your dropper before you use the paint. Grab a toothpick and stir, stir, stir. Make sure everything is mixed together very well. You could also use a paintbrush for this to really get in there and stir, but be sure to wash your brush in the cleaning jar, not in the dropper bottle, of paint thinner when done. As you mix it around, don't smash the bristles of your brush too much either, or you'll ruin its shape. Anyway, as you mix, you will see the paint start to thin out and flow more smoothly. The consistency when you finally bring paintbrush to model should look like this. Not watery thin, but not thick and gloopy either. To start painting, always select the smallest brush that will get your job done. You can always switch to a bigger brush, but starting with a large brush may cover up details with paint, or apply the wrong color to areas that you didn't want to paint at all. Try to keep your jar level as well. If you turn your jar upside down, paint will run into the lid, which will then cause the lid to stick or just waste paint. To begin, don't dunk your paintbrush all the way down into the jar, getting paint all the way to the top of the bristles or even on the handle. Just dab a little bit of paint onto your brush and get to work. I'm painting a small tire in this video. If the paint seems too thin and you're thinking, hey, I can still see gray plastic through this coat of paint, that's okay. Just give the piece another coat or two. Too little paint is better than too much paint. Again, it obscures details. Oh, and be sure to let the first coat dry about 15 minutes before you begin your second coat. Often, you'll want to create a custom color. To achieve this, simply take a few drops of one color, a base color, and a few drops of another, or multiple others if you're getting crazy with it, and mix them together in your palette. Remember the ratio of drops in case you need to recreate that color again in the future. Always clean your paintbrush. If you let paint dry on the brush, it will ruin the brush. To clean it, use the jar of thinner, again not the dropper bottle, and swish the paintbrush around in the jar. I like to gently act like I'm painting the bottom or sides of the jar too. You then run the paintbrush along a clean section of paper towel, moving from handle to tip of the bristles. Don't squish the bristles or rub them backwards, as it will eventually ruin the paintbrush's shape. Repeat this until the paintbrush doesn't leave any paint color on the paper towel. Thanks for watching, and keep watching the series of videos for more advanced techniques and for how to add finishing touches to your model, like decals.